It's been a busy few days. Last week in the House, I was in the debate for the Environmental Protection Authority Bill. This is a bill which will create a standalone regulatory authority which will coordinate protection of our environment at a national level. Debate will continue today. Friday was torrential rain interspersed with periods of drizzle in Manurewa, but I managed to get up about 45 signs advertising our next public meeting in Manurewa with the Honourable Phil Heatley. He'll be talking about housing our people at 7 o'clock on Tuesday the 31st of May in our normal venue, the Manurewa Methodist Church. We're getting good turnouts to our meetings and it's proving very popular in our community. In the evening, I was privileged to join the Honourable Georgina Te Huhu at the Cero Pacific Health Awards. National is awarded over 200 awards to young Pasifika students in the health disciplines over the last 2 years. This compares with about 20 in the previous 8 years. So we're making very huge amount of progress there, and it was great to see these young students being supported by the government and of course going on to do so well for themselves but also for our community. On Saturday morning, I went to a couple of markets, and then about 9:45 I was at the opening of the refurbished Manurewa Rugby Football Club club rooms. I've been a member of the Manurewa Club for a number of years, and it's certainly great to see the refurbishment carried out to such a high standard. It was a club rooms originally built by volunteers almost 40 years ago, and it's situated in the beautiful Mountford Park and a very, very strong asset to our community. Sadly, Rewa got thumped by Karaka last week before last and went from top of the Premier Division to fourth, but we're certainly hoping they'll pull themselves back and get through to the finals. On Saturday, it was another busy day in the electorate, and culminated in speaking on behalf of the government at a function celebrating the 150th anniversary of that wonderful polymath Renaissance man, Tagore. Tagore was born in what is now Bangladesh, and the function was put on in a cooperative manner by the Bangladesh Association and the New Zealand Indian Central Association. Tagore is perhaps the only man who's written a national anthem for two countries, India and Bangladesh, and the message that he has resonates today. It was a great privilege to be there. Thanks very much.